And because of how fast and how quickly it's growing, it has now become a $1.6 trillion industry, which is not only in Muslim mature markets such as Malaysia and the GCC, but now we have countries such as the UK in Europe setting themselves up to be the Islamic financial hub of Europe by setting up the first Islamic bond, which is going to be put on the London Stock Exchange. Luxembourg for the longest time has been an offshore center for Islamic finance, and Ireland has been showing interest as recently as, you know, even this year. So it is an industry that is now crossing beyond faith, and people are recognizing that, you know, it makes viable business sense to transact in Islamic finance. Somebody saying how they would borrow 100,000 from somebody and then return to them 110,000, and if this is riba. This is riba because what they are transacting in is making money the commodity. There's no underlying asset here. He's basically doing business and then just, you know, trying to guarantee that this is the profit he will make, and then that profit is not a profit because it's interest. Several reasons. Because first, in Islamic finance, we don't view money as a commodity. We just say it is a medium of exchange. Hence, it has no intrinsic value except what we give it, meaning that you cannot use money as a commodity, which is what they're doing. The money is making money. Whereas we in Islamic finance believe that it's the underlying transaction based on a contract with an unknown asset that allows you to make a profit. So no, that scenario that he has given is riba based. Now the other person asks, what channels can they use for Islamic finance because they are very wary about what is on offer. Well, basically all the Islamic banks and Islamic windows that we have are offering Islamic finance alternatives. So what they have to do is go and speak to any of these banks, a relationship manager, and see what they have, what products they have on offer, and then utilize that. Because at least what these banks have done, gone out of their way to do, is have a system by which they can offer their clientele Sharia compliant products.
For more great content, check out ummah.co.ke, and don't miss out by following us on Facebook and Twitter and subscribing on YouTube.